aware, for those of us who may not be aware, but you guys are a very vocal group who has had some tremendous results over the past number of years. But I want to know, what is Aware Simcoe? What do you do, and what do you hope to achieve?
Well, basically, Aware Simcoe started up last May. It has concerns about governance within the county and within our townships. Mm-hmm. And we just feel it should be a little more transparent, mm-hmm. a little more accountable. And we'd like to see the public input listened to a little bit better. So this group came together partly as a result of Site 41 and some of the issues that were raised around that. We're concerned about waste management here in the county. We're concerned about our water situation. And right now we're very concerned about the growth plans that are expected to come forward for Simcoe County and what's mm-hmm. happening in that area.
Now, because it's such a broad, you're focusing on so many things. You guys are the watchdogs, as you described yourselves. How are you able to focus and be so well organized when it comes to focusing on such a big mandate?
Well, I think, again, out of Site 41, we had a lot of organization there. The people that were involved in that organization have pulled together. We have great networking. We have an overriding or family aware for all of the county, mm-hmm. smaller aware groups within each township. We liaise back and forth, have regular meetings. And in fact, tomorrow morning in Alliston, there is one at 9:30 in the morning at St. John's on Victoria Street, St. John's United Church. Mm-hmm. We're right now concerned about the property developments at Site 41 and questioning the county on why they're moving ahead so quickly on this, considering the fact that a very prominent scientist, Dr. Bill Schottick, has put forward a proposal but hasn't managed to get the sort of business plan pulled together. Mm-hmm. He asked the county for a year to do that, but the county seems intent on going ahead and selling off a portion of the property and not leaving it for him to try and develop in a positive way for all of Canada, really, mm-hmm. in water development and water conservation.
Mm-hmm. Now, speaking about water, because obviously a lot of people in this area are very well educated on Site 41, just the whole process and the whole battle, what was going on there. Everyone knows what Site 41 is. Another issue that is coming forward in Simcoe County is, you know, talking about the watershed. Tell us about that and how you're focusing on trying to create some change.
Well, tomorrow the meeting in Alliston is focusing on this mega-quarry that's proposed over near Shelburne. It's going to impact on the Nottawasaga watershed, which is about 50% of the county of Simcoe. And it could devastate our water supply. When you start digging a hole 200 feet into the ground, start impacting on huge amounts of acreage, and impact on the headwaters of a lot of the major rivers in south central Ontario, it's a pretty serious thing. And we're hoping that our government, the provincial government, and also the county governments over there, and Simcoe County, will provide input so that this doesn't go ahead and impact people the way it's obviously looking like it might.
Do you find that just with your dealings with Aware and going through a lot of environmental concerns, do you find that more people are more aware of what is going on with the environment and development at the same time?
Well, we're hearing much more from individuals. We came together really to encourage people to get out and vote at the municipal election, mm-hmm. look very carefully at the elected or the people running for election, and also taking a look at the administrative staff that works behind the scenes developing programs to bring forward to council. The big problem in Simcoe County is we have 32 councillors. All of them represent their own municipalities, and it's very difficult and very taxing for them to keep abreast of everything. So through Aware, we hope through our website and our liaison with the public mm-hmm. to keep people more aware of what is happening in the county so that things don't happen behind closed doors and there is accountability and transparency.
How do you think we can best find the solution to make that possible?
Well, right now, I guess people should join Aware. People should go on our website, should see what we're doing, why we're doing it, and be informed really about what's happening in their county. Mm-hmm. It's a very big county. Different issues north, south, east, and west. All of them impact on all of us mm-hmm. and the citizens of southern Ontario. So be aware, get out there, watch what's happening, be informed, and do the right thing by the people of Simcoe County, really.
And tell us quickly again about this event that's taking place tomorrow. Where can people get more information? I'm assuming your website, but tell us what they can expect if they go to Alliston tomorrow.
Well, it's pretty exciting. One of the individuals on the panel is Mr. Goldhawk from Zoomer Radio in Toronto. Another one is Jeff Manag from Bosley First Nation. the gentleman involved over, I think he's deputy mayor of the township where this mega-quarry is going to be.
So it's an exciting event with a lot of different perspectives that's being held through. Where Don, thank you so much for joining us. Really appreciate it.
Thank you, Jennifer, for the opportunity to let people know about Aware.
All right, you just heard it here. Don't go anywhere. We got more to come right here on Daytime.